The world is getting closer to mass vaccination, but a big question mark still hangs over the origin of COVID-19. Finding out is the mission for a team of international investigators, including an Australian professor. They've now gained entry to Wuhan, China, to go back to the beginning.
Touchdown Wuhan, a year after the outbreak, China lets the world in.
There is a huge yellow plane behind me.
State media broadcasts live to hundreds of millions as officials in full protective suits welcome 13 masked scientists, among them Australian microbiologist Professor Dominic Dwyer. The mission to find out what caused coronavirus.
The outbreak certainly started in China. Whether the virus started in China is difficult to tell.
A year ago, 41 people were infected. That's now 93 million and climbing. About 2 million have died. The scientists' work has already started during 14 days in quarantine before they'll visit wet markets and hospitals.
It's about trying to shine a light on how this process happened. Whether it was in China or not, I think is key.
Beijing initially blocked access but has opened the door. China will support the WHO experts, the foreign ministry says. The government hopes that happens, having pushed for this investigation into the virus.
We want to know the origins and the causes of the pandemic.
Australia's call for an inquiry is high up on China's grievances. Beijing has since targeted Canberra on wine, barley, beef, coal, cotton, timber and seafood.
We'll never trade our interests or our values.
Beijing is adamant the virus started elsewhere and won't call this an investigation, insisting it's international cooperation. Either way, it's not just Australia wanting to know how the virus started, but other governments around the world to try and reduce the risk of another deadly pandemic.
We are looking for the answers here that may save us in future. Not culprits and not people to blame.
Jonathan Kersley, Nine News.
Those who've recovered from COVID-19 are likely to be immune from the virus for at least 5 months. A London study of 6,500 healthcare workers showed just 44 developed symptoms a second time. But researchers are warning recovered patients can still spread the bug. Meanwhile, chemists in the UK have started administering COVID jabs after the country again recorded its deadliest day.